I'm Amaury, and today I'm going to answer a question from Sasha, the co-founder of a B2B marketplace. His question is, what's the difference between a server and a cloud hosting? And before answering this question, let's add a bit of context. Sasha and his co-founder already developed the first version of a product. They are now undertaking the version 2 of their development, and they are considering moving to Amazon Web Services as a cloud hosting solution. Moving an application to the cloud is usually a very good option because we are not renting a server anymore, but we are buying a delivered service instead. And let's make a quick explanation. When we use a classical server, basically you are in a data center. This is a data center. Then you will rent one server here. And in this server, this one will belongs to you. You will put some database, some files for your application, as well as your application. Let's say that we put everything in a zip file. App.zip file. That's everything that will be on your server. The point is, if something goes wrong, like if for some reason this server crash, you lose everything. And that's really a shame, because in that case, what you need to do? You need to get another server, maybe on the same data center or somewhere else. And you need to, hopefully, you have some backups. So you might have some backups for your application, your files, and your database. Maybe that's going to be some old version of the backups. And you will have to reinstall everything on a new server and then move the domain name on the new server IP. That can take something between 1 hour to 24 hours to solve everything, if you already have the skill set to manage it. So, that's basically complex. Now, let's see how cloud services works. For example, Amazon Web Services build data center all over the world with thousands of computers. When you use their services, you basically do not have one server attributed to your service. But the service you buy will be dispatched across dozens of servers and even across several data centers. Let's see how it works. So basically, on this data center, you will have several services. You will have services for applications. You will have services for hard drive or storage. Then you will have services for maybe AI, artificial intelligence, or backup services, etc., etc. That's not one server that will be dedicated to one service, but that's a group of servers that will be dedicated to one service. And the beauty of a real cloud service is that you just need to worry about developing your application. And if something goes wrong, and if everything is set up correctly, the cloud handles everything. You don't even have a downtime. The downtime is the time where when the server crash, maybe your website is going to be down and not working. It doesn't happen anymore when you are on a real cloud server. The cloud provider use what we called a load balancer, which switch clients' requests from one server to another automatically. Basically, here is how it looks like. This is a load balancer. The load balancer will get a client request. When you have someone in front of his computer, he's going to ask for something. This request will be automatically dispatched to one server. And if this server crash at the exact same time, it's not a big deal, because the load balancer will automatically dispatch the request to another server, etc., etc. And even if you have thousands of requests, all the requests will be handled automatically by a bigger amount of servers. So I think you get the point. You don't need to have an engineer 24/7 available. No need to spend days and weeks setting up manual architecture manually. we can build on a cloud provider, similar architecture to large companies, which a very high reliability with still being a startup. So basically, any technical issues are under the responsibility of the cloud provider, which makes the solution more reliable with automatic failover and with database as services, which enable you to handle all your data with a single service. And you don't need to be worried about if your server crashed or not. And that also allows you to build a high availability architecture, which means that it's going to switch from one server to another if there is any issue. So to conclude and answer Sasha's questions, with the cloud solutions, any technical issues are under the responsibilities of the cloud provider, which makes things easier and more reliable, or with automatic failover, database services, which is a lot easier to manage, backup and restore, and also with a ready-to-use high-availability architecture with almost no downtime. So the last questions you might ask is, what are the drawbacks of a cloud architecture? And I can see three small drawbacks. First, the technology dependencies. Secondly, the costs. And third, the application need to be adapted for it. And this last point is especially what I'm going to talk about in my next video. What changes need to be made on an application to be cloud compatible? And now if, like Sasha, you have a specific question for your project, just go ahead and ask on myctofriend.co/ask. I will do my best to answer your question by video or to redirect you to existing content that will answer it. And also be sure to go through other content at myctofriend.co to learn more from growth startup experience and better manage your startup development. Waiting for your question, I look forward to seeing you in other videos. Cheers.